should get going.
All right, let's go.
Shit, where's my phone?
Good question.
It's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Betcha Rachel, Amber has it.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's.
Rachel Amber's gonna answer. Ha! That's what I'm betting. I remember this house.
Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it.
Sounds like a plan. You know, these doors were all fake. Mom just painted them.
The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, Scourge of Arcadia Bay.
That into pirates, really?
Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair's his kryptonite. Hmm. Maybe I should dye my hair gray.
No, dye it blue. Long-lasting gray coverage, no ammonia, sunrise almond. That's it. Don't gotta go boop. Go boop. All right, let's go. Beecher.
Home sweet home. Whoever said you can't go home again was probably from Arcadia Bay. And he could go home again. He just didn't want to.
Huh. It's funny, in the first game, you're playing as Max, but you spend more time in this house than in her own. Because, you know, it's funny, because I don't even remember.
I think Mom's phone is in her bedroom.
I don't even remember Max's house. Maybe a little, just a little bit of it. That's the phone. A ring?
Mom's old engagement ring. Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married.
Hmm.
Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pawn. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring?
No kidding. But first you look at the grade B, and then you realize what it is all about. Grade B, so you'd get $300 in cash or $500 for store credit. Hmm. Nah, cool. Don't sell your ring. You gonna sell the necklace too?
I made this for Mom when I was like 10 years old. If she wore it now, I'm not sure which of us would be more embarrassed.
Hmm.
I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad.
Oh, take it out, put it on the dresser. Chloe's very rebellious, so that wouldn't surprise anybody.
You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this.
As far as rebellious things go, that's actually nothing. That has consequences. Well, good. Was it purse?
Can't believe I used to sneak in there for her makeup.
Huh.
Dad, if you could see us now.
I know the phone's over there.
I want Mom to be happy, but not like this. Not like this!
Love After Loss, a guide to forgiving oneself and moving forward. There's also a read besides the other read.
Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were. Blech. Don't give up on yourself. A single spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie.
Sounds great.
Better.
It's still 7 o'clock.
It's weird that Mom's always hoarding these old catalogs. It's not like we have any money.
Huh. This is where all the action happens. Ugh.
Mom's finally making her bed again? I guess that's a good sign.
She's ready with David. I'm guessing, but he hasn't moved in here yet. That's what it seems like.
Ah, Mom! Bad enough that David comes here for dinner.
Yep. Hasn't moved in here yet. Sorry, Chloe. Yeah, worse things are coming as far as that.
I should call my phone.
Let's see if my prophecy comes true.
How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating?
I don't know. How do I call the phone? I guess I hit back. Oh, it is in the house. You hold the phone and you go looking for it. Why'd you put it down?
My phone is definitely nearby.
You hold it so you can...
Ugh. I drank way too much last night. Or was it just enough?
Why'd you put it down? You hold it so you can ring it again if you have to.
There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
I was thought for sure Rachel Amber had it. Like, hey, I have your phone! And that gives them a chance to, like, meet up again. Where's that Elliot guy? Who left that note? Mom. So this goes in... Okay. Will you be coming home at some point tonight? Okay, I'm trying to find, like, in order. Yeah. Will you be joining us for supper? Chloe says no thanks. Will you be coming home at some point tonight? Will you be home by curfew? There will be consequences at 1:17 in the morning. Yep, that's what we know. Consequences. Well, we're gonna find out anyway. Elliot? To the beginning. Okay, May 6th. Spanish test sucked. Lucky if I passed. Chloe says, aw. Lo siento. No, I think I did okay. Chloe says, cool. What you up to? Not much. Got shit to do later. Oh, okay. You finished the chem homework? Nope. Dude, that's the third time. Chloe says, I already know everything. Frank? April 3rd. Your shit's here. In all caps. She writes back, hell yeah. But tapped out, sorry. Frank says, you're a loss. Hey, can you hold it for me a day? Can I? I'm your favorite customer. Are you? Frank, you holding? Oh, this is like... This is 17 days later. 420, I get it. 420, Frank, you're holding. You still owe. You gonna have me whacked? Yes. Please joke about that over text. You deal drugs on this phone. Anyway, come on, it's 420. I'll meet you if you have the cash. Arg, rain check. Well, we finally got to pay him. I wonder if we're going to run into that guy who was selling a t-shirt to them. Oh, Max. Oh, she saved all these old texts. November 2nd, 2009. So we're now in May something? Max says, so sorry, I've been bad about emailing. Texting is better for me anyway. Chloe says, yo, it's Max. How's it going? You there? Really? So she responds right away at 2:14 and doesn't hear from her until 11 days later. Max says, gah, sorry again. I've been really busy. You'd love Seattle. More in a bit. She writes back the same minute. Chloe says, cool. Maybe some hitchhiking in my future. November 27th now. Hey, hippie. Next day, 28th. I'm so sorry. Maybe we should set up a time to call. No worries. She texts back right away. I'll check my dance card. It's a few minutes later. It's 7 p.m. in Arcadia Bay. What is it? 2019 in Seattle? Max does write back right away. I know, right? Maybe this weekend. Sure, anytime. Let me know. It's November 28th. December 14th. Yo, Queen of the Crickets. What's the latest? January 3rd now. Max. And that's it. She gave up. I don't remember what Max's excuse was. Something like, I don't know. It was awkward. She didn't know how to... I don't know. She wasn't good at keeping in touch for some reason.
Chloe, breakfast! Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
See how hard it is?
You saw Mom's purse in her room?
Yeah, we saw it. See how hard it is just to be a teenager? It took us this long just to get dressed, find our phone, now we have to get this purse, and we could finally go downstairs. See if she says
something. Take that down to Mom.
Yeah, I wanted to see if she said something different. Which she did.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone too?
Oh, brother.
No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Oh, I didn't have to do that.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry.
Mm-hmm. Well, I don't think there's anything else to do up here, so let's go down.
Coming, Mom.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Mm. Yeah, you know it's gonna take me forever to
dining
do that.
Dining table, here I come.
Yeah, after we look at everything.
David's here so early. Mom calls him just a friend, but look at him. He's pretending he didn't just spend the night. Mm. And you never saw the condoms, Chloe. You never saw the condoms.
You can't unsee it. It's impossible. These photos.
Dad took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere.
You can just erase everything like that. Can't check the answering machine like we used to.
Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year.
Hmm. Arcadia Bay companies support our vets. Job fair. Real recruiters want to meet you. Wednesday, April 1st. Okay, so it's April. Arcadia Town Hall. Resume resume assistance. Career counseling.
Any letter from Blackwell is never good.
Blackwell Academy? Yeah, open it.
Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything. Like I need another reason for Principal Wells to get on my case.
That's right. It's a private school, not just for photography. Forgot about that. The amount owed is $550. The future needs excellence, so pay us now.
Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max? And never looked back?
What does it say, Reed? Oh, we can flip it over, I guess? Captain Chloe Bluebeard, Scourge of Arcadia, and her first mate, Long Max Silver. Can it flip? Wait.
Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max? And never looked back?
I really thought I could flip that over and that would be written on the back.
We're already supporting one. Thanks. Dad always talked about upgrading to a flat screen. Too bad that never happened. I would have gotten this bad boy in my room.
Another removed photo?
Family pic used to hang here. Wow. I can't actually remember which one. Hard to believe I was an eighth grade science athlete. Did I peak in middle school?
Oh, you're going through a tough time.
From when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad at me.
Yeah, I'm sure that's the reason.
It's my job to water these plants, but it was Dad's job to remind me, so. Nobody's fault, really.
Yeah. Chloe has interesting thought processes.
Haven't really felt like sitting down to eat since David started having dinner here.
Do not blame you.
Made that for Mom in an art class when I was like 5. She was never a smoker, but it's cool. I was never an artist. Wait, those aren't Mom's keys. And these would be David's keys. There's probably a better place for them than the ashtray I made Mom. Like his home, maybe?
U.S. Army, this will defend. Newspaper.
Shoot. I was hoping David could get a job on a container ship. To Japan.
Oh, so it is May. May 7th, okay, 2010, Friday. Shipyard closing. Though real estate developer Sean Prescott promised that employee layoffs would be minimal when he purchased the shipyard, he announced this week that he will be ending operations effective immediately. In a move not surprising to longtime residents of the region, the Prescott Foundation also liquidated the Arcadia Bay Stevedores Association's defined pension plan. Michelle Kinsey Robertson, staff attorney for the foundation, defended the action as our right in recouping unrecovered losses against debts owed. Sean Prescott could not be reached for comment. Of course he couldn't.
Why do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
A wildfire warning has been issued for all residents of Arcadia Bay. Fines doubled for illegal fireworks and campfires in unauthorized areas. Yep, just you'll pay more money, that's all.
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt. Thank you. Also, Chloe, you're poor and in trouble.
Arcadia Bay Gazette tuition hike. Let me be emphatic. This is not due to financial woes, says Principal Ray Wells. After a survey of the tuitions of prestige academies of similar caliber, we are simply keeping ourselves competitive. Blackwell parents invest in their children, not their vacation homes. Wells further emphasized that, in addition to merit-based tuition awards, this year won by sophomores Stella Hill and Brooke Scott, the school's program of need-based scholarships remains in place for students who maintain exceptional academic records. Which is not Chloe Price, unfortunately. Snowdome?
Feeling trapped? Right there with you.
It's very splashy.
Little dude's like, what the hell just happened?
I never shook a snow globe and it completely splotchy like that. The stuff inside, like the snow kind of stuff, is supposed to shake around, not the water. It's supposed to be pretty much full.
Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk.
What kind of cereal is this? I can't see it. There's all sketchy stuff all over it.
How can bacon smell so good, but I'd still rather stuff these sugar bombs in my mouth?
Because those are yummy too?
Pot roast? Mom hates pot roast.
Then guess who likes pot roast then?
It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food.
Now, I'm kind of torn between just putting the purse on the table and then talking to her. Will I still have the opportunity to talk to her if I put it...
Mom's purse is pretty heavy.
Yeah, we're tired of carrying it, aren't we? So if I put this on the table, is this going to get slipped to a cutscene? Should I talk to her now? Or if I talk to her now without putting the purse on that, will there be consequences for me not... Screw it. I'm Chloe Price. And that's just my mom.
Joyce Price, a.k.a. Mom. She looks as beat as I feel.
Go put my purse on the table before you forget.
Okay, we have to do it. What kind of... I want to know what kind of cereal this is. It's just sugar bombs, right? I can't get too close, or the sketchy stuff goes on there. Okay, Mom.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
You
sent me away. See what Mom wants before she strokes out.
You sent me away to go put this here. That's why I'm not next to you.
Got Mom's purse. Still exhausted. Better not do any more good deeds today.
Yep. No more errands. All done. What's that say? Love you, Mom. It's still 7 o'clock. Time is frozen in place! Aye!
Joyce Price, a.k.a. Mom. Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
I was busy.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
You don't have to say message. Sorry, I'll do better.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Mom, remember that.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
I guess the ones that underlined are important. I want to ask about the engagement ring, actually.
Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Yes or no?
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
You
How about
set
you
me
don't ask me to get your damn purse, then?
And phone. You told me to go in there to get your phone and purse. And the ring was on the dresser that the purse was next to. David?
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole.
Pot roast?
I thought you hated pot roast.
You can have a no thank you helping.
No, you hate pot roast. I don't care.
David likes
pot
roast.
I don't hate it. And David likes it.
Ta-da.
And don't say you don't care.
So that's what we're doing now? Whatever your boyfriend likes?
Okay, so we do get an option to check, you know, choose all of them anyway.
Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
She's being serious.
I made you breakfast.
Nah. I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, what are you gonna eat?
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break curfew.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that-
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? And I do know what pot smells like, you know. Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
This is way too much eye makeup.
Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Never again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
That is a good point. Maybe David could help since he spends so much time around here.
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself. David thinks you need discipline.
Oh, brother.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
I'll whoop his ass. He's an asshole.
Your boyfriend's an asshole!
He's been good for me. Maybe he rubs you the wrong way because you've been rude.
He's still breathing. That means I've been more than fair.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
Ugh. That's what's gonna happen.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too.
But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not?
Let's be understanding.
Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
No, just okay, you babe.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Got it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too.
Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
She could do worse, but yeah, that's kinda... You can see how you wouldn't like it.
Breakfast. The most important fight of the day.
Come on, sweetheart. I'm sure David's waiting for his keys.
It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food.
Yeah. Really, huh? Does she say the same stuff? Let me see.
Dad's old swear jar.
Yep.
We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk. Almost wish I could slip Mom cash. If I had any cash to slip.
We gave it to freaking David. $200. Still broke up about that.
I made that for my mom.
Yep. He puts his filthy keys in there. Ugh.
No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I'd better get going.
No, I'm going back upstairs. I'm going to sleep. I'm gonna go to sleep. Go upstairs. What force is stopping me? Mom! Alright, let's check. How do we even check that? How do I... Hold on. How do I check my phone? Objective, maybe? No, it just says bring keys to David. Maybe I have to press it when... Yeah, I want to read that.
Mom said David is driving me to school. If this is a nightmare, now would be a great time to wake up. Scream it.
Scream it. I don't know how to check the phone. Hold on. Unless I can do it through here now. No, I don't know. I probably have to hit it when it does, when I get a new message. Hopefully I get to check it soon. Got a message from somebody. Is that a raven?
What a piece of crap. The car, too.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're nice. Hoping you men will leave without us.
I remember a scene very like this one.
No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
I remember this exact scene, actually.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh.
Better just get the socket wrench and get this over with. Mom should date literally anyone else.
Where's the socket wrench set again? All I see in the garage is family stuff. You know. Not your stuff.
Dick around on your own time. It's in the toolbox. In the garage. Won't be late to school on my watch.
Yeah, I will if I just take forever to find it. Let's do other things instead.
Tiniest penis in all of Arcadia Bay.